Cada um. Okay, so we are now at the armature windings of alternator. So we already started discussing this last meeting, the two arrangement of the armature windings for alternator. So we have the single layer windings or the half coil, and the other one is the double layer windings or full coil. So in the single layer winding, as we discussed last meeting, the number of coil size that is placed for every slab is only one coil size, so it should be looks like this. While for the double layer, so this is for the single layer, for the double layer, so there are two coil sides that are placed for every slab. So we will illustrate now this arrangement in our discussion here. Let's consider an example for the single layer. Let's consider a circular diagram for the armature winding. So in this illustration, there are 36 slats. So we have 36 slats for poles. So we have four poles. Okay, so for every line in the armature, so for every line here, will represent one slat. So hindi na ipinakita dito. And so there are 36 slats here. Then if you're going to place the winding, say this winding, which is only the winding of one phase. So our discussion here about the armature winding is the winding of a three-phase alternator or three-phase synchronous generator. So in this illustration, there are two coils for every pole. So I will make a color here. So we have here a blue color. This is for the for phase A in one pole. Okay, so this is one pole. Then the next winding for that phase A is again here. So nandito naman siya. For phase B naman, if you're going to place phase B, should be connected also here. So it should be looks like this. And so this is also connected in series to come out with that. Then for phase C, so it should be also this one. So that is phase C. So we have phase A for the blue, then phase B for the green, and phase C for the red. Then susunod naman dito is phase A. Then meron naman tayong phase B, phase C. Then next naman is phase A, phase B, phase C. So you will notice here that the number of coil size that is placed for every slot here is only one. So that is the single layer. And usually the arrangement for the armature for AC generator is usually similar as in the lap winding. But the only difference is yung coil ends nila are not connected to the commutator. So usually the coil end should be connected such that it makes the coils to be connected in series and in order to produce a certain direction of the current. So makita natin the connection later on. And after that, after connecting phase A together, and also phase B and phase C, then you can connect now the winding as Y or delta. So ipakita ko mamaya yan. We go with the double layer windings. So we have also an illustration here. The same number of slats. So we have 36 slats. The number of poles is also 4. And then we're going to place the winding similar as in the half coil. Then for phase A alone, it should be looks like this. So maybe we started here. Yung lagyan ko ng kulay. So this is the first coil. And then another coil that is placed now for the next slot. So usually connected in series yan. Then next na coil is, this one is already placed at the same slot. Okay, yung susunod dito. Gawin ko na lang green. So yung green na side of the coil is placed now at the same slot as in red na coil. So ganyan. So bale, there are two coil sides here. So coil sides per slot. So yan. So makita natin na mas marami yung number of coils now for the double layer or whole coil comparing to the number of coils in the half coil. Also, the number of coils per pole, per phase in the armature winding is usually called as the group. So, ito. So, consider this, okay? So, these two coils here is usually located as the number, these are coils found in one pole per phase. So there are two coils here. So here is considered as one group composed of two coils. Yun ang tinatawag natin na group. So this is considered as one group, another group, and so on. So the number of groups for this illustration in the whole coil is we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 groups in one phase only. So we have 6 groups per phase. So that the total, if it is 3 phase, so times 3, so we have 18 groups for this arrangement. While in the single layer, we have only 3 groups. 3 groups per phase. Times 3 will give only 9 groups as the total number of groups in the armature winding. So that is the arrangement for the half coil and the whole coil. Then let's say to compare now this two arrangement of the windings in terms of the number of coils, the number of groups, and the number of turns. So for the second column is for the half coil or single layer. The last column is for the whole coil or the double layer. So in the number of coils for half coil should be equal now to the number of slots divided by 2. So kung tingnan natin sa example natin, na there are 36 slots. Therefore, the number of coils in that arrangement na half coil is 36 divided by 2. That is equal to 18 coils. So, kung we go back with the figure, so if we get to count the number of coils in one phase only, yung original na drawing natin, there are 6 coils that are placed here, okay? So, bali tatlong groups ito. We have 2 coils in a group. Therefore, we have 6 coils. And it is 3 phase. So, bali tatlong ganito yung ilalagay natin dito. then it should be 6 times 3 will give to us 18 coins. While in the whole coil, the number of coils is equal to the number of slots. So since there are 36 slots, therefore the number of coils should be 36 coils. So kung bilangin natin lahat yan, so this is only phase A. We have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 coils in one phase. So another 12 for phase B, another 12 for phase C. That will make a total of 36 coils. Then the number of groups. So for half coil, it should be the number of phases multiplied by P over 2. So there are 4 poles for this, 3 phase. Therefore, the number of groups now for the half coil should be equal now to 3 times 4 divided by 2 is we have 6 number of poles. So it should be 9 groups. So 3 times 6 over 2 is 9 groups for the half coil. So ito yung groups na tinutukoy. So in the drawing for phase A alone, there are 3 groups. Another 3 groups for phase B, similar as this, but it is only out of phase by 120 electrical degrees. Another same arrangement as this for phase C. Therefore, we have 9 groups. While for the whole coil, the number of groups is equal to the number of phases multiplied by the number of poles. So it should be 3 times 6. So there are 18 groups here. So kung bilangin natin, in our drawing, is only one phase. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 groups. So another 6 groups for phase B, another 6 groups for phase C to make it as 18 groups. That is equal to 3 times 6. Then the number of turns, it should be 2N turns for half coil, while N turns for the whole coil. So if you're going to compare the total number of turns for the half coil and whole coil, still the same. So kung i-compare natin yung dalawang example natin na in half coil, there are 18 coils. While in the whole coil, there are 36 coils. Then say example, for every coil, we have, lagyan natin ng numerical value, we have 10 turns per coil. So, if 10 turns, so we have 360 for the whole coil, but in the half coil, it should be times 2 of this. So 10 times 2 is 20 times 18 is still 360 turns. So the total number of turns is still the same for half coil and whole coil. Okay. So meron tayong another illustration here. This is now a complete winding for a usually whole coil ito, 3 phase. So one ko lang yung number of slots for this. So in the illustration, there are 3 coils in a group. So this is considered as one group composed of 3 coils. So makita natin na tatlo yung coils na nandun. So ang pinakamataas na winding dito is the winding for phase A. Then I will it draws here another row for phase B and another rows for the other phase, which is phase C. But usually, it should be placed at the same row sana yan, okay? Para hindi tayo magulo sa pagtingin dito sa drawing, they separated the drawing for phase A, phase B, and phase C. So for phase A, So it should be connected like that. So meron tayong starting here na phase A. So dito tayo mag-start. Then i-connect natin yung mga coils na group, usually connected in series yan. So we connect at this point, yung SA. Then the current now will flow at the right side. So the direction of the current should be going to the right. Then for the next group, the direction of the current should be the opposite of the first one. So how could we make the direction of the current to be in opposite? So after the first group na nakakonect in series, it should be connected now to the last coil in the next group so that the direction of the current should be in that direction. So it should be counterclockwise. And the ending now of the group should be this one. So makita natin. Then opposite again for the next. So it should be again started here. Then opposite, similar, okay? So ito yung ending niya for phase A. So starting and ito yung ending, okay? For phase B, so it should be again started at this point. And so it should be this one. So going to the right. Then next should be going to the left. So the same arrangement and so on. So interval lang yung direction of the current. Then meron tayong ending for phase C. So again, this should be the direction. So also, if you're going to observe the direction of the current for every group, for phase A, phase B, and phase C, they should be in opposite direction. So kung tingnan natin, kunain natin yung phase B going to the right, then phase A going to the left, then phase C going to the right. So that is in opposite direction. So again, next na naman yun is phase B, so opposite again, then and so on. Then after that, if you connect this one in Y, so we will connect all the ending together as the neutral point. So the output now of the generator should be extracted now from here, okay? So yung phase A, phase B, and phase C. So this is the arrangement, okay? So yeah, so if you're going to see here, it is a simple lap connection, but the only difference now here is we will not connect the coil ends to the commutator, but instead we connect them in series and connect them to the other groups by satisfying the direction of the current. So kung hindi natin i-connect yung neutral point, so walang connection yan. Yung phase A is usually an open circuit starting from the starting point to the end point. So it will not go back to the starting point, so open circuit. Ganun din sa phase B, so open circuit then naging closed circuit lang due to the connection now of the neutral point if we connect them in Y. You can also connect in delta if the design is delta. So you know now how to connect delta. So I will illustrate. So in the illustration natin dito, so in phase A, we're going to represent now one coil. So meron tayong ang mga subscript natin dito is SA. So maybe starting of phase A, so finish of A, so F yung nakalagay. Then meron tayong connection for phase B. So meron din tayong finish ng phase B, starting of phase B, and another phase, so starting for phase C, and finish of phase C. All the finish or the ending are connected together to come out with the neutral point. So, or also called as the star point. Then dito natin i-extract yung output na of the generator. So this is for phase C, phase B, and phase A. So that is for the Y connection. So you already discussed this connection in your three-phase circuit. While for delta, should be connected like this. So assuming this is for phase A, this is phase B, phase C. This is labeled as starting of phase A, finish of phase A, starting of phase B, finish or end of phase B, then starting of phase C, end or finish of phase C. To make this one as delta, the ending and the beginning should be connected together for its phase. And dito natin i-extract yung output of the generator. That is for delta. Okay, so that is the connection. So print kayo kailan. So I will check the attendance mamaya para makita ko yung absent. Okay. So that is for the connection or arrangement now of the winding. Then we go now with the formulas for the speed and frequency. So for the frequency, so it is the number of cycles generated per complete revolution. So you already discussed the derivation of this in your subject in AC circuit and also in electrical machine 1. Kasi ito, review lang natin. In one revolution, if you consider topples machine, so we're going to place a conductor here or a one loop coil, okay? So isang ikot yan. So parang ganito siya. Yeah, so we have one turn here. If you try to rotate this one in one complete rotation, the generated voltage should be looks like this. A conductor AB, conductor CD. So if the conductor AB will pass through at south pole, it will produce a point direction, while conductor CD will pass through with north, it will produce a cross direction, so that the total voltage generated should be the sum of the two, assuming that they are out of phase by 180 electrical degrees. So yeah, and then if you're going to further rotate that, then the tendency is the generated voltage will increase now from zero to a maximum when the coils now will cut the magnetic lines of force in parallel. Then it goes to zero again if conductor AB is dito sa baba, conductor CD is at the upper portion. Then if we further rotate that, the current now will reverse. So the generated voltage now will go to the opposite direction until such time that it will go back to the original position now of the conductor, such that AB is on the upper and CD is at the lower. So in this arrangement, we have only one cycle generated and one revolution. So, and but if the number of poles is already naging apat siya, so there are four poles like this, we're going to place a coil that is placed like that. So similar arrangement as that. If you're going to move this coil such that it will be rotated in one complete rotation, usually the number of cycles generated should be two cycles per revolution. So if the number of poles is six, usually there are three cycles per revolution. So the formula to determine the number of cycles per revolution should be in this formula, should be P over 2. That is the number of cycles generated per complete revolution. So if the speed of the revolution is, or the rotation is in revolution per second, then the frequency now should be equal to the number of cycles generated per revolution. So P over 2. So ang unit natin dito is cycles per revolution multiplied by the speed in revolution per second. So yung revolution dito sa P over 2 is nasa baba. Yung revolution dito sa speed is nasa taas. So makakancel yan. And the unit now here is cycles per second. If you want to convert the speed in revolution per minute, which is usually the usual unit of speed, that is revolution per minute, then the formula will become the speed in RPM. So lagyan ko ng subscript to identify that the speed now is in RPM divided by 60. So yung speed in RPM divided by 60 is still the same as revolution per second. So that this one now will become P times N all over 120, where our N is in revolution per minute. So that is the derivation of the frequency. So P times N in RPM all over 120. Then now we go with the generated voltage for the armature winding in the alternator. So it is stated here that an average of 1 volt is generated in 1 turn of wire if the flux passing through that turn changes at the rate of 10^8 Maxwells per second. So in formula, the average voltage now should be equal to the number of turns multiplied by the rate of change of flux. Okay, so that is V over T times 10 raised by negative 8, where N is the number of turns in the coil, V is the flux per pole with a unit of lines or Maxwells, then time is, or T should be the time in seconds for flux to change by the maximum value of the flux. So if you're going to see the time, it should be looks like this. So the flux produced there is also sinusoidal. So this is the waveform. And the maximum value should be this one, P maximum. And the total time per complete cycle in terms of the frequency is equal to 1 all over F. So, kasi kung baliktarin natin yung unit ng frequency na cycles per second, so it should be second per cycle. Okay, so that is the time now here. If you consider only 1/2, we have 1 all over 2F. So it should be, mayroong clerical error dito, it should be 1 over 2F. And also, kung consider natin up to the 1/4, so it should be 1 all over 4F. So the time to change from 0 to maximum is 1 all over 4F. So ito yung tinutukoy na time in the formula. So if we substitute now this time as 1 over F in the formula, then the average generated voltage will become N times V over 1/4 F times 10 raised by negative 8. And if you're going to arrange this, we have now 4 F and V. Usually the flux, now V is in maximum value, times 10 raised by negative 8. So this is the average average voltage, but we are in AC, so we're going to determine the RMS or the effective generated voltage. So you know now what is RMS, the root mean square value or effective voltage. So how could we convert this average voltage into RMS? So we will use the form factor of the waveform na sinusoidal. So I think you already discussed this from your circuits, that the form factor is equal to the RMS value, so RMS value divided by the average value. And usually the form factor for sinusoidal waveform is 1.11. So you can derive that, okay? So kasi in sinusoidal, you already discussed that the RMS value in terms of the maximum is to be maximum over square root of 2. So this is the formula, okay? So maximum divided by square root of 2, while the average is twice the maximum over pi. So makakancel yung maximum, then from here we can determine the value as 1.11. To multiply now 1.11 with the average value, then the RMS value now of the generated voltage is equal now to 4.44 multiplied by the frequency in cycles per second multiplied by the number of turns, total number of turns per phase, then multiplied by the flux per pole at maximum value times 10 raised by negative 8. So yung phi natin or flux is in Maxwell's or lines na unit. But if you use the other one, the SI unit, which is the Weber, usually ma-cancel out yung times 10 raised by negative 8 because 1 Weber is equal to 10 raised to 8 lines or Maxwell. So yung 10 raised to 8 na positive multiplied by 10 raised to 8 negative will cancel out. So mawala yan, okay? So this formula of the generated voltage is there is a certain error. Meron siyang error because the assumption in the coils are the span of the coil is 180 electrical degrees, so 180. And it is also assumed that all the coils are placed at the same slot, not distributed. So, but in actual, the coils are usually distributed along the armature core. So in this formula, in-assume niya na it is placed at the same, all the coils are placed at the same slot. So i-correct natin yan as we go on with our discussion. So we go with the coil pitch and pitch factor. So unahin natin yung pole pitch. So pole pitch is the distance in terms of electrical degrees between two adjacent or opposite poles, and it is always equal to 180 electrical degrees. So if you going to consider this arrangement na two poles, yung distance between adjacent poles is always 180 electrical degrees. So another 180 at the other side to make this one as 360 electrical degrees in one rotation or one round for two poles. So that is always the case, okay? Basta yung distance between adjacent poles should be always 180. Even the number of poles will change. Say four. So if we have four poles, so the distance pa rin, maybe from the center to center of the next pole, is still 180 electrical degrees. And this distance is called as the pulpits. So, depende dyan pang measure, maybe center of the pole to the next pole center or midpoint, midway between them. So, still 180 electrical degrees. So, that is for the pulpits. Then we go with the coil pits. It is the distance between the two sides of the coil. So, there are two arrangements here in AC. Pero tayong tinatawag na full pits. So, if the distance between coil sides is equal to 180 electrical degrees, while for the fractional pits, if the distance between coil sides is less than 180. So, I will illustrate this one. So, first is the pole pits. So, assuming meron tayong dalawang poles dito, north and south. And meron tayong armature core here. Looks like this. So, maybe the one coil is placed like this. So, maybe exactly yung isang side ng coil is exactly at the center of North Pole and the other is also at the center, okay? So that the distance here is 180 electrical degrees. So, if that is the coil pitch of the winding, then tawag natin doon is full pits. And for the fractional pits, so if you consider the same, eh, meron tayong islet na ganito. And the coil is maybe placed like this. So makita natin na yung distance natin dito is less than 180 electrical degrees. So, that is the arrangement. So, we have advantages for arrangement na fractional pits. So, there are three listed here that they save copper of end connection. So, if you're going to see here, yung mga end connection natin dito, ito yung mga end connection natin, okay? Yung part na ito ng coil, or I will draw another. So, ito yung mga end connections natin. So, kung full pitch siya, mas mahaba yan, okay? Longer comparing to the end connections for the fractional pitch. So, it will save copper conductors due to the end connections. Number two, they improve the waveform of the generated EMF can be made to approximate to sine wave more easily and the distorting harmonics can be reduced or totally eliminated. So, if you're going to compare the generated voltage between the full pitch and the fractional pitch, mas malinis yung output yung fractional pitch. So, it reduce the harmonics. So, you don't know what is harmonics. So, one is it will distort the fundamental waveform so that the total is distorted siya. Parang you're going to draw the waveform. So, parang meron siyang space spike na ganyan. So, that is the effect of the harmonic. So, considering the fractional pitch, we can reduce now the effect now of harmonics. Then number three, due to elimination of high-frequency harmonics, eddy current and hysteresis losses is usually reduced. Because one factor for those losses in the iron it is made up of eddy current loss, and hysteresis loss is also depend on the frequency. Okay, so alam na natin yan from your machine one, na eddy current will depend on the frequency also with the hysteresis loss. And the only disadvantage is the total generated voltage around the coil is reduced. So, mas maliit yung ma-generate natin na voltage comparing to the full pitch. So, makita natin yan. Then, we go with the pitch factor. So, we let the pitch factor represented by the variable Kp. It is the ratio between the generated voltage in fractional pitch and that of full pitch. In formula, pitch factor Kp should be equal to the vector sum of the induced EMF per coil divided by the arithmetic sum of the induced EMF per coil. So, i-illustrate natin to. So, we go back with our drawing kanina for the full pitch and fractional pitch para ma-derive natin yung formula for this. So let's consider a full pitch. So assuming the distance now here is exactly 180 electrical degrees. So for every side of the coil, say it will generate a voltage E. So at the left side will generate a voltage E. At the right side will also generate a voltage E. And the total voltage here, the total voltage should be equal now to, since they are displaced by exactly 180 electrical degrees, then the generated voltage should be in phase or the same direction. So it should be illustrated like this. We have a vector here to represent the generated voltage at one side. Then the generated voltage at the other side should be also like this. So they are in phase, so that the total voltage is simply the sum or arithmetic now, or arithmetic sum of the voltages generated by its side. So it should be twice E. So twice E yung ma-generate natin na voltage. But in the fractional pitch, so I will draw also an illustration now for the fractional pitch. Okay, so this is 180. Then this is only the coil pitch. Okay, say the angle is P degree. And the angle difference now between the coil pitch and the fractional pitch is, say, we let alpha. So that the total now 180 still the same as P degree plus alpha. So still the generated voltage per side of the coil is E, but the total voltage is not the sum of these voltages because they are not in phase. So if you're going to draw the phasor diagram, say we consider the generated voltage of one side to be our reference, then the generated voltage is E, then the generated voltage of the other should be displaced by an angle alpha, so that the generated voltage total should be the geometric sum now of these two phasor. So this is the total generated voltage. So e-total. So usually if you're going to consider the total in complex form, it should be e. So it should be e angle 0 plus e angle alpha. Or in conventional formula, let's say to rotate the phasor by alpha over 2 so that the phasor now will be looks like this. So this angle is alpha over 2. Same also at the other side, alpha over 2. They are still generating voltage na E for its phasor. Then the geometric sum now is already at the horizontal, like this. Ito na yung E total natin. So yung E total natin, since if we're going to divide this, so one half of that is equal to, that is the horizontal component, it is now equal to E cosine of alpha over 2. So E cosine of alpha over 2, that is one half of the E total. To come out with the total, it should be times 2, kasi parehas lang naman sa other side. So it should be equal now to this one. So that is for the fractional pits. And based from the formula for the pits factor, it is now equal to the generated voltage at fractional pits. It is now equal to twice E cosine alpha over 2 divided by the generated voltage at full pits, which is simply twice E. So makakancel yung twice E. And remaining is meron tayong cosine of alpha over 2. So that is the one formula for the pitch factor. We can also transform that cosine into sine. Dito na lang ilagay. So pitch factor Kp, it is cosine of alpha over 2. So alpha is equal to 180 minus p degree based from our illustration divided by 2, or simply cosine now of 90 minus p degree over 2. So applying the identities, the trigonometric identities for the cosine of the difference of two angles, yung cos cos sin sin. So meron tayong cosine 90, cosine of p degree over 2. Kung minus yan, it should be plus. So sine of 90, sine of p degree over 2. We know that cosine 90 is 0. So the first term now will become 0. Sine 90 is 1. Therefore, should be equal now to sine of p degree over 2. Where our p degree is equal to the angle of the fractional pits. And so we can use cosine or sine. But if you consider now sine, the angle should be the angle of the fractional pits divided by 2. While using cosine, we use the angle now, the difference between 180 and p degree divided by 2, or simply alpha over 2. Okay, so that is for the pitch factor. So we will incorporate this pitch factor in the formula for the generated voltage for the alternator so that we can correct the arrangement of the coil. So whether it is a fractional pitch or full pitch. If it is full pitch, the value of the pitch factor is usually 1, okay? But assuming that the coil is not a full pitch, fractional pitch, so i-correct natin yan by incorporating now that factor in the formula. Usually, we're going to multiply this factor in the formula that we discussed kanina. That is Pitts factor. Then yung factor na susunod is the distribution factor. So ito naman yung factor that will correct now that the arrangement of the coil is usually distributed. So this naka-distribute siya. The assumption in the formula is they are concentrated in one slot. So okay, so i-discuss na lang natin ito. So when several coils in a group are connected in series, the total voltage generated by the group is not equal to the voltage per coil multiplied by the number of coils in a group. So let's say to illustrate that. So let's consider one group. Okay, so let's say to consider, say, three coils in a group. So assuming we have a coil like this, one, cut na lang natin. Say this is one coil, then we have another coil like this, then another coil, say three coils. Usually these are all connected in series and meron tayong beginning and ending. So this is one group composed of three coils. So assuming that the generated voltage for every coil is E. So what should be the total voltage here? So if the coils are usually placed at the same slot, usually the total voltage is simply 3E. But since they are displaced by every slot per slot yung distance, then the generated voltage is not in phase. So if you're going to illustrate now this one, maybe a phasor to represent its generated voltage of the coil. Say the first one should be E, and assuming that the angle between adjacent slot is D degree, then the next coil should be in this direction. So this should be D degree ang angle niya. That is another E. Then for the next coil, we have again another D degree, so that the total generated voltage for the distributed coils in a group should be this one. So ito yung total voltage niya. But if the coils are usually placed at same slot, so usually the total voltage is 3E. So 3 plus 3 plus 3. So ang formula natin dito sa KD, so the EMF with distributed windings, so usually yung illustration natin dito, then divided by EMF when concentrated winding, so it should be the sum of the voltages. We let the variable ED to represent the EMF with distributed windings, and a variable EC to represent now the generated voltage when they are placed at the same slot or concentrated windings. And meron din tayong another formula here for the distribution factor. So KD is equal to sine of N the degree over 2 divided by N sine of the angle D degree over 2. So yung D degree is the angle between adjacent islet, and our n is the number of elements, or sorry, element coils per group. Yeah. But in our discussion, we will use the first formula. Kasi mas madaling i-familiarize yan comparing to the second one. Okay, so we will illustrate further this formula. Again, this distribution factor should be incorporated also in the formula in the generated voltage of an alternator so that we can correct it. Okay, so that's all muna. So we will solve problems next meeting, how to compute these factors and also with the generated voltage as using the corrected formula. So, okay.